Good evening and welcome back to Twin State Sports. I'm Zach Siminar. The Mississippi State men's golf team opened up NCAA regional round play in Kentucky on Monday by shooting a 10 over par. And another challenging day on Tuesday has put the Golf Dogs in a hole that may be insurmountable. Both Peng Peekakul and Ford Clegg did their part today by moving into the top 15 on the individual leaderboard in a tie for 11th, but no other Bulldogs can be seen inside the top 45, which has put MSU in a tie for 9th place overall, 14 strokes out of the final transfer spot into the NCAA championships heading into day 3. Which tees off tomorrow morning from Simpsonville, Kentucky. Things have gone a bit more swiftly for the Ole Miss golf team out in California, who are in the thick of contention as day 2 comes to a close. Freshman Sarut Vongchasit led the Rebels on day 1 with a career best 66 to lead Ole Miss on the individual leaderboard at 3 under, but the Thailand native took a bit of a step back on Tuesday, leaving the Rebels clinging to the 5th and final transfer spot into the NCAA championships that get underway next week in Arkansas. The Rebels own a 4-stroke lead over LSU going into the final day of regional play. Everyone is chasing the home team Stanford, who has a 10-stroke lead on second place UNC. The New Orleans Saints rookie minicamp wrapped up over the weekend, and one of the Saints' rooks who's turned heads over the last 3 days was linebacker Caden Ellis. The 7th-round draft choice out of Idaho is the perfect kind of fit for Sean Payton, a versatile athletic player who spent time on both sides of the ball, playing tight end and linebacker in college. Has similar traits to Taysom Hill, and if he's able to hang around, his flexibility will allow him to flourish.
You know, I think I can do a lot for the team. Any team that, you know, you can try to plug me in anywhere. I'm going to do my very best at whatever you're asking me to do. And I think I have some different skill sets that allow me to play multiple positions. And whatever they ask of me, I'm going to do. And I'm going to do to the best of my ability on special teams and on defense. And I'm going to go out there and I'm just going to fly around. So, yeah, it's just a blessing to be here.
Next time we can expect Ellis on the field comes next week when OTAs open up on Tuesday. The 101st PGA Championship gets underway this week from Bethpage Black in New York. The tournament features 156 players forming the strongest field based on official world golf rankings. This is Tiger Woods' first tournament since he won the Masters in April, and he talked today about preparing for the tournament.
Feel rested and ready, and that's going to be the interesting part going forward. How much do I play and how much do I rest? I think I've done a lot of the legwork and the hard work already, trying to find my game over the past year and a half. Now I think it's just maintaining it. I know that I feel better when I'm fresh. The body doesn't respond like it used to. It doesn't bounce back quite as well. So I got to be aware of that.
Now, it could be a challenge for Tiger, who will have to clear his head of some off-the-course issues he's been dealing with. Woods is being sued after a person died from being overserved at his Florida restaurant. The parents of a bartender who worked at the Woods Jupiter restaurant filed a lawsuit today claiming their son died at the hands of being overserved alcohol. Nicholas Imusberger, who struggled with sobriety, was served after his shift on December the 10th. 24-year-old drank more than 3 times the legal limit just before he drove home. Imusberger later crashed his vehicle and died.